Hello, everyone. Welcome to Carbs Against Humanity. I am super excited because today we are making sausage and garlic pizza. It's low carb. There's really very little carbs. Most of the carbs is going to be from the marinara sauce that you put on top of the pizza. So I'm really excited. Let's wait for to see if we can get more people to join in. And if you are logged in and you're tuning in, could you put a quick note and let us know where you're from? We are shooting from Manhattan Beach today, and I'm gonna go check on our comments to see if I can. See if I can see any comments from you guys. So if you just tuned in, this is Charlene and we are making sausage and garlic pizza today. It's low carb, it's keto friendly. So yeah. How are we doing? Can you guys hear me okay? Cannot see the feed. All right. I see it now. Awesome.
Can you guys hear me okay?
I did not want to see that.
Okay.
Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and get started on just introducing this recipe. So I'm super excited because the main ingredient of this low-carb pizza, basically the pizza dough, is pork rinds. Right here, you can get a lot of, you can get this whole big pork rind container from Amazon if you want, or you can use any pork rinds you want, but basically it's sort of like breadcrumbs. It attaches, or it absorbs all the stuff that we're putting in and makes really, really good, really yummy crust. I mean, seriously, since I've done this recipe, I cannot have any of the like cauliflower pizza because it just doesn't taste as good. So I'm going to start, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you the ingredients for the pizza crust. So to make the pizza crust, you're gonna need 8 ounces of cream cheese. I always use the whole fat. 3 eggs, 2 cups of Italian style cheese. It's also called, you can also see it's pizza blend. You'll see that sometimes. But really it's a combination of mozzarella, provolone, parmesan, and Romano cheeses. So if you don't want to buy the Italian mix, you can just basically, make your own. And you're also going to need 1/4 cup Parmesan cheese. You're going to need 1/2 tablespoon of garlic powder and 1/2 tablespoon of Italian seasoning. And then you're also going to need 1 cup of ground pork rinds. So that's really the ingredients that you need. The rest of the ingredients, just so you know, is the garlic, the Italian sausage, and the marinara sauce, and the additional cheese is for the topping. So let's go ahead and make the pizza crust. And by the way, guys, Anne, do you want to say hi?
I'm coming.
Anne is in the back, hi. So she's going to help me with any comments and read through any of your comments just so I can see you. Don't forget, make sure you tell us where you're watching us from today. We are shooting in Manhattan Beach. It's really hot in here right now. That's why I'm sweating already. So let's go and make up this dough. By the way, before you start making the pizza dough, you're going to need to preheat your oven to 425 degrees Fahrenheit. All right, I'm going to go grab a bowl. bowl is going to be, this mix is super easy to make. I have my bowl right here and a wooden spoon. And let's get started. And maybe you can play some music for us.
Sure.
Fun. How are you guys doing? Let me know how your afternoon is going. It's Thursday. And the week is finally over. But here's the thing, I can't believe that it's already September. Isn't that crazy? I mean, it's almost Christmas. Whoa, where did that come from? Okay, so what I'm doing is this cream cheese is softened or pre-softened. I just left it out for 30 minutes or so. And I'm just gonna put that in my bowl. Go. Mix that up a little bit. Like so. Make a mess in my kitchen. So I put the cream cheese, and then I am putting, I'm going to put all the different cheeses first. So I'm putting the Italian mix, 2 cups of that, and 1/4 cup Parmesan. So there's going to be a lot of cheese in this recipe. You don't like cheese, look away. So you just mix that up like so. Alright, and now I'm gonna put 3 eggs. Didn't crack that one right. Oh well. Who's and there's another. Alright. Hey everyone! If you just tuned in, we are making sausage and garlic pizza. It is low carb and keto friendly. And I just put 3 eggs. This mixture is basically cream cheese, Italian cheese, and Parmesan. So I'm just mixing it like so. I'm gonna show them my. Here you go. You can see it. And then I'm going to put the garlic powder and the Italian seasoning. Make one big yummy mixture. Here you go. Once everything is mixed up like so, you want to put the pork rinds. Yeah. So the pork rinds, it kind of acts like breadcrumbs, or how breadcrumbs would. Basically, it absorbs all the cheese, and then it sort of just makes it taste really crusty, really like a pizza crust. I mean, this is a pizza crust, but there's no flour in it, so it's very, very low carb. So if you see, this is my blob of cheese and pork, basically. My blob or my pizza video is done, now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to put it in the pan. So what I have here is my pizza pan, and because this is a different recipe, we're gonna use parchment paper so that my dough won't, you know, go through all those holes. And just put it on top, and then get my blob ready. Literally just put it in there. What? Very sexy. Sexy and cheesy. All right. So, here we go. So now I have this really big, yummy blob of cheese. And what I do is you want to kind of make it spread a little bit. So I don't know about you, but I like thin crust. So I'm gonna try as much as I can to make this crust thin enough for pizza. So the way that I do it is I get another piece of parchment paper, put it on top, and just spread the dough. It's really pretty spreadable, and you know, you don't want to roll it, like, I'm definitely not going to throw it, like, in a pizza parlor, because I cannot. But you can definitely push it out. Another thing, if you have a rolling pin, you can roll it out. For me, I don't have a rolling pin, but I have a water bottle. And so I'm just going to roll it out with my water bottle. It doesn't really have to be perfect, because at the end of the day, it's going to just flatten out anyway. So you see how it's rolled out already, a little bit more rolled out. I'm gonna put that back in and roll it out a little more this way. Roll that out. Roll this out. More even. Yumminess. Yeah. All right. Yummy. I am so tempted to just dip my finger in there. I'm not gonna do it because there's raw eggs in it. So, I've rolled out my my pizza dough into my pizza pan, and I'm gonna go ahead and put it in the oven. So my oven is set to 425, and here we go. So you wanna have that in there for about 20-25 minutes or so. I'm gonna start with 20. See how it looks after 20 minutes, and then check on it. Now, I cheated a little bit because I did make a pizza dough in advance. Because otherwise, what am I going to talk about for 20 minutes with you, right? So, let me see if this is... Oh, let me grab a... Okay, so here, I just made this pizza dough, but basically, now, here's how it looks like when it's all done. So this pizza dough just cooked, and basically, we're now just gonna pretty much put toppings on it. So, I've told you guys about this before, but 2014 it was. 3 years ago, my husband and I lived in New York, and there was this amazing, amazing pizza place called John's on Bleecker Street, and it's my favorite place, and I always try to copy their pizza as much as I can. Obviously, when I go to New York, I'm just gonna go there and have it. for now, the toppings I'm going to put is inspired by John von Leeker. So they have this sausage and garlic pizza that I just absolutely love. So what I have is, for toppings, is you can buy this. It's called Cantella's Italian Sausage. You can buy it at Ralph's, or actually no, mostly it's in Vaughn's. And it's great because it's already pre-mixed, and it has fennel, which I think is the key, because that makes really good, sausage for pizza. So I'm just gonna cut some garlic. Cannot cut my garlic today. Alright. Come on, garlic. Yeah, got it. Let's say about three segments of garlic. I think that should be good to start. This is how I take the skin off my garlic. It's very, very fashionable. Pound that garlic. Okay. So now you get the skin off. And we are going to cut some pieces for the sausage mix. So what I like doing, super easy. We're just gonna fry up some garlic, and then we're going to cook the sausage a little bit before putting it in as a topping. Okay? There you go. So let me know what you think. By the way, this recipe is part of the meal plan that we have at Hip Shake Fitness. It's called, we have this program. It's called Bootylicious 7. And it's 7 days of dance workouts and a meal plan. So it has a lot of recipes, and they're all low carb. And there's like meals, there's snacks, just drinks. It's just, you can really make a full meal plan for a week. And yeah, it comes with your Hip Shake Fitness subscription as part of it. All right, so oops. Pretty clean, because my counters are clean, I promise. All right, so we are gonna go back into over here so that we can cook the sausage. There you go. So I just have a small pan. I'm gonna put some olive oil. Heat that up a little bit.
Charlie Bean says looks awesome.
Hey Charlie, if you want, you can pass by. Got pizza for you. It's low carb. Who else is in there? I can't read. I can't see the.
There's about 11 people.
Huh. Call them out.
I can only see 9 and Charlie and Kenneth.
Oh, 9?
Mm-hmm.
Charlie, who else?
And Kenneth.
Kenneth, hi. Hey. Kenneth, I think, is from Capoeira. And 9 from Philippines. Yay! Okay, so I am making the sausage topping for the pizza. And I have my olive oil and it's heating up. I'm gonna put some garlic in it, in there. It smells so good. I love the smell of garlic. Garlic. I don't know about you, but I love a lot of garlic. So, since it's my pizza, I'm eating it and put as much garlic as I want. And I'm just gonna put this Italian sausage mix from Cantella's. Now, you can just make your own mix. You could just get sausage, but what I love about this mix is it has fennel, which I think makes really good pizza. So just put it in there and brown it up a little bit. Hey, Bowie. Alright, I'm gonna wash my hands a little bit. Okay, so I just wanted to just cook the sausage a little bit before putting it on the pizza, and then because I think it just tastes a lot better when you cook when the sausage is pre-cooked before putting it on the pizza. So we just want a little bit of brown. Ooh, I can smell the garlic. It smells so good, guys. And if you're watching, make sure you let us know where you're at, where you're from. It's always really good to find out where everyone's from. I've gotten people from Brazil, from different parts of the U.S., and people from Manila, where I'm from. It's just really an international world we have here. We welcome everyone, and we're happy to have you.
Angela is watching from Texas.
Angela, hi! Texas! Oh my gosh, I hope that you're okay. I know there was a huge hurricane in Texas, and people are still recovering from it. Okay. So, maybe a few more. As you can see, there's still some pink in my sausage. So we are making the topping for our sausage and garlic pizza. We just finished making the crust, and we are now making the toppings. And this is sausage from Cantella's. It's Italian sausage. I just bought it from Vaughn's. It's really yummy. It has fennel in it, but you really can put any topping in a pizza. I also really like marinara. What is that called? Sometimes I just want to keep it simple, so I'll just put mozzarella and tomato sauce and basil. That's really good too. You might like pepperoni on your pizza, pepperoni mushrooms, always really good. Just love pizza. Okay, so this is pretty good. It's not yet super cooked, just a little bit, but because we're gonna put the pizza back in the oven anyway. So here's what my sausage looks like after I cooked it a little bit. And here's my pizza. Now I'm gonna decorate it. So let me open up this pizza sauce. But there's really nothing crazy. But I did want to give Charlie Bean a shout out because she told me about Rao's homemade sauces. And what it is for if you're eating low carb for pizza, for this specific pizza anyway, The most of the carbs really comes from the marinara sauce or the tomato sauce. So, and it's actually really hard to find low carb pizza sauce or pasta sauce. So this Rouse is really good. This one serving of this, which is a half a cup, is only 5 grams carbs. So thank you, Charlie, for turning me on to Rouse. And I am going to use their roasted garlic sauce for the pizza today. Yeah, so we're literally just making pizza. So just put the sauce on top, like so. Maybe a little more. See some crust here. A little more in there. Nice. I am getting hungry already just looking at this and just making this. And then basically just put the sausage on top the way you wanna, however way you want it. I love a lot of sausage. So this can be beautiful. So this is sausage and garlic mix. And this sausage and garlic pizza is, if you're just watching, it is part of our Bootylicious 7 program at Hip Shape Fitness. We have 7 days of booty workouts, and we have a meal plan, and it's all available part of your membership. And we have tons of other programs too. We have Booty Boot Camp. I think that's 2 weeks of booty workouts. If you're a beginner, we have Beginner Hip Shaker, which really breaks down dance or just learning different steps for you. We have tons of different dance workouts in Hip Shape Fitness. Okay, so now I think I have enough sausage. Actually, I'm gonna just put everything in there because it's gonna be so good. And then the last part is, of course, put your cheese. Yummy. Oh, I'm so excited to eat this. So this is pizza blend. It's basically mozzarella and parmesan and romano. Really, you want to make sure you have mozzarella in there. But if you want to get this pizza blend, it's pretty good. Okay, so now I have all this ready. Maybe a little cheese. I'm just going to put it back in the oven, probably for another 5 minutes or until the cheese bubbles. You see, we have our other pizza crust. I'm gonna lower the oven temperature because my oven is really tricky. It sort of heats up more than it should. But yeah, that really is all there is to it. We are posting the recipe in this thread. If you have any questions, please let me know. I hope you love your low carb pizza. It's really great. It's really good to substitute pork rinds as a good way to make things low carb. I actually will substitute it for for, what do you call this, for breadcrumbs. So, like, if you wanted to make fried chicken with breadcrumbs and that kind of stuff, it's a really good substitute. And, yeah, thank you so much for watching, and we will see you on the next live stream.